has been washed. If I was there.
I seen. Get the exclusive, Elie.
Yeah, listen, be good to people, be fair, fair and balanced.
Don't, hey man, you deserve it, bro.
Everybody wants a negative headline that'll give them the most views. I don't care about that. Right? Be a good person first.
You get it.
Yeah. Are you friends with Tyson Fury?
No.
You don't interact with him, right?
Nah.
Him and Joshua, who wins?
It's a good one. Yeah, it's a good one.
By the way, Rick, your manager, went off yesterday on Twitter. Did you see what he said?
I saw he posted a long paragraph.
Yeah, he did. I didn't read all of it. It was too much to read. Rick, next time break it down for us people that only can read small paragraphs. But he said basically, why is ESPN promoting Thriller when they're not promoting their own fights?
Well, he was trying to put, the Golden Boy, Top Rank, Al Heyman, match from boxing. And Eddie Hearn does a good job, I think he does a good job. He treated me really well when I went to go fight Hooker.
That was a great fight, by the way.
But, when they see a network like Twitter, who's never promoted boxing ever, understand the importance of promotion and...
$1 million pay-per-views?
And they think outside the box, you know what I mean? They bring entertainers, they bring something new to the table, right? That entertains some boxing fans and a lot of non-boxing fans. And they're generating money to pay the guys in the card. So it seemed to me that was what Rick was trying to make a point to the promoters, not the networks, but the promoters who have these networks to get behind them and they seem to kind of not catch up to the new resources that we have now with social media and other different
celebrity. You're absolutely right. They're stuck in 1970. You're right.
They're kind of stuck in the old fashioned of promoting, right? But
because it's been working for them, but they didn't adapt. I agree.
But they need to adapt. They need to adjust and they need to learn and grow. But for me, I don't see that card besides Regis fight. Besides Regis, I won't take credit away from him. But besides him, I don't see that as a boxing card. I don't see it as a boxing card at all. Like, the whole show shouldn't be like a boxing match. It should be like a new sport, like something different, something outside of boxing.
J-Rock, Julian like Williams, said no, he was like, this is what Ann won the basketball.
Exactly.
To the NBA.
Exactly.
It's still basketball, but it's entertainment.
Exactly. So that's the way I see it. I see it as not being boxing, but being something similar to boxing with
an entertainment value.
With certain rules, there's certain regulations on some of the bouts and some rules that they could do. On the fights. And then there's some that were legit boxing fights. Like 181, 190, those catch weights, they just wherever they show up. Like Ben looked like he didn't work out,
Well, he usually fought, when he was a pro fighter, he fought at lower weight classes, but he didn't gain the weight by working with Charles, getting in shape. He gained the weight probably by just eating. And the way he was hitting the bag really just, I thought he was trolling everyone because he looked terrible, Jose.
Well, he doesn't box.
No, but
he's not saying he's a boxer either.
Yeah, but you're a professional fighter. Boxing's part of fighting. That's what I thought.
But MMA, UFC requires other different skills.
That's true. If you're a good wrestler, you're great. How would you do in the octagon?
Not very good.
Hey, at least you're honest.
Who knows? I might get a lucky punch, right?
There are no lucky punches, Jose.
Oh, there's some. In a street fight, there is,
Yeah. Sorry. ¿Cómo estás?
Bien.
¿Feliz? Charles, if you would have trained Ben Askren, you would have had a body like Anthony Joshua.
I thought you were going to say Andy Ruiz.
No. Andy Ruiz is actually in great shape right now. I went to see him last week.
Here's the thing about him. You know, Kobe said he lost a lot of weight or this or that. You know what? I would go into that fight, every fight, being the exact same guy you were against the first fight with Joshua. You were tremendous. We know his condition was great.
He's in a great place right now.
Guess what? He was fast. He was powerful. He had conditioning.
And he's great.
You can't judge him by the physique, right? He was a tremendous athlete in that fight. I wouldn't do anything different. That was the fight of his life, right?
That's true.